We're doing some flip practice today with Kai. We want to start out her freestyle career by teaching her to flip. It was one of the first things we learned to do with Lilli. With Lilli, how we used to watch on TV, because all we did was toss and fetch, but we would watch TV and see these dogs doing amazing tricks, including the flip, and we just thought the flip was the coolest. Andrea found John Arnett on the internet, on his website at aircanines.com with a Z, and we met with John, and he did a clinic for us, some toss and fetch, and he taught us how to do the flip. And it was probably more technical than this, but all I really remember John saying was something like, you know, just throw it like this. So after six or more months of flipping with Lilli, she's really great at it. Now Lilli made it easy. Maybe not every dog is going to be natural at flipping. We're going to see how Kai does today. Next, Andrea is going to go over the basics of flipping, and she's going to show you how we flip with Lilli, and then we'll do some practice with Kai.
You're anxious, aren't you? Yeah, you're anxious. That's a good girl.
So today I'm going to show you what Lilli's flips look like. My flips are a little different from the traditional flip throw. I like to pop it right up at this angle, at a 90 degree angle, right over the dog's head. And I basically came up with that because the regular flip throw was a little bit unreliable for me. They ended up kind of going all over the place when Lilli was learning, and this was the one that I could control even if it was in the wind or if it was in a short distance or a long distance. So I throw my flip like this at a 90 degree angle, and where we're looking to throw it is right over behind the dog's head at 10 o'clock and 2 o'clock. So either right here or right here behind the dog's head. And what that does is it forces them to jump up and over for the disc because of the position. And you can do it at any angle from 90 degrees all the way to 45 degrees in either one of those spots. So whatever throw works best for you, any of them will work for a flip.
You can talk all you want, but my skin is really thick. I'm the leader of the crowd and my game is really slick. I'm unstoppable, unstoppable, unstoppable.
So what that makes available for Lilli is that she can choose whether she wants to flip left or right. And even though there's a little bit of a breeze today, I could just put it up right above her head, and she could take the disc without it being affected by the wind.
So Andrea's throw style, wait Lilli, is a lot more precise. She essentially drops it right into the spot that she wants it to go. The general throw isn't quite as precise, although once you practice it, it will be. And it's more of a regular toss. You're just tossing the disc. Sorry, though. I mean, so you want to practice with your dog. Just make sure you throw it all different directions, all different ways to get a feel for what your dog's best at. I like to throw mine straight up, just slightly off center, and see how high I can get Lilli to go.
You can talk all you want, but my skin is really thick. I'm the leader of the crowd, and my game is really slick. I'm unstoppable.
And then, of course, you have variations, like one we just did this weekend, where it's a butterfly.
So I started a session with Kai, especially because she's a beginner disc dog, it's important to connect with her and give her a reward. So the tug is a reward that gets her excited. Okay, we're going to do some simple flips with her. Because she's a novice flipper, a novice frisbee dog, we're not going to expect her to get the same height that Lilli would. So I'm going to put the disc in the same way, but I'm going to put it a little bit lower and right behind her head. And what I would like for her to do is just get the motion of tracking the disc and getting her body to roll over in that flip motion. The most important thing with her is just to get her to track the disc behind her head and start to actually move her body in that half a moon motion.
I don't know what's going on.
Different directions and different heights and see, you know, what she seems to be strong at. Overweight. I'm going to make sure you warm them up and that you really enjoy the experience. Some great places, resources for you in regards to flipping are canineathlete.com. That's with Ron Watson and April Lee, and they have a lot of great information on flipping, charts, and discussions and videos on it. You can always email us and we're happy to talk about it with you. So good luck and enjoy your flipping with your dog.